Today I'll explain the function of the known good battery to you. This is a very useful tool for doing diagnosis while you're repairing one of these modern machines. It is a little board that pretends to be a battery. It connects to the battery. This is where the flex cable connects, just like on the normal batteries. And the fold over flap that screws with the big screw connects here. Here's a little notch, which corresponds to the aluminium ridge in the computer at that point. Here's the plug where you can plug in your power supply. There are a whole bunch of LEDs. This one shows if there's a problem with the system presence line. This is the line that the computer uses to tell the battery that there is a computer in the first place. The I2C bus LED will blink a number of times if there's a problem with the I2C bus. The SMC LED will blink whenever the SMC in the computer is talking to the battery. The SMC might be integrated into the T2 chip, but it's still an SMC and it works like one. Then these two LEDs will light up if it sees an ISL charging chip. There's one LED for the 9239 and another LED for the 9240. Depending on which kind it sees, it will light up the appropriate LED. If PP3V3 G3 hot is present, then this LED will light. And if the known good battery sees a PMIC on the motherboard, then the PMIC LED will light. So all in all, it's a very useful tool, which will give you extra information for free, effectively. It is very little work to connect it, and it will show you things that might be useful in the repair. Here we have a MacBook Pro, A1708, which is dead as a doornail. It does not charge, it does not power on. And I will show you the known good battery in use on this. The known good battery connects to the power supply and it pretends to be a good battery, hence known good battery. This way we can feed the machine from the power supply, bypassing the charging circuit of the Mac. Okay, let's connect it. I'll show you how to connect it and we'll see what happens. So first we disconnect the battery. We disconnect the screw. And we have to use the appropriate cable on the known good battery. So the smaller models with two ports connect on this side with one cable, and the larger models with four ports connect on the other side with a different cable. But this one goes here. Close the latch. The board has a little notch in it so that it can fit snugly without having to take the board or the battery out. And then we insert the little connector on the motherboard. Now we connect it to the power supply. The power supply is set to 13 volts. And it was already on. So you see several things are happening here. The orange light shows that the known good battery is powered. The three green LEDs in a row show that the charging voltage is present, but in this case it's coming from the power supply, so that's also pretty obvious. Here, the top green LED shows that it sees an ISL 9239, which makes sense. Here, the bottom green LED means it's happy with the PP3V3G3 hot in the Mac. So at least that line is working. And the PMIC LED, it shows that this little board is talking to the PMIC in the Mac. So the I2C bus is up and running. And it manages to talk to the ISL, and it's managing to talk to the PMIC. Not all models have a PMIC, but this one does, or at least one that it can talk to. So we know those two chips are talking, so at least not very dead. Now we can power the machine on and see what happens. Now you see the blinking on the SMC LED. This means that the SMC woke up and the SMC is now talking to the battery, or talking to our known good battery in this case. The machine is drawing 1.1 amps at 13 volts. And we have an image. USB-C's tester is happy as well, and it's showing that the processor is running, but we have an image, so obviously the processor is running, but we see that from the USB-C tester as well. So in this case, we know that the machine is, as a computer, working just fine. There is no problem with the computer part of the computer. The problem will be somewhere in the charging circuit, or maybe on the other USB-C connector, I don't know. But it will be a relatively easy fix. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this interesting. Please visit our site, cmizapper.com, and check out our products. This one is called the Known Good Battery, and it is available for the A1708, amongst other machines.